Greetings from the Remnant Bible School Church. Amen. Getting to know him, saints. We have to study to make ourselves approved. As a workman rightly dividing that word of truth, we bless the Lord. We're getting to know him. From the male and the female perspective. From a perspective of divinity and intercessory prayer. From a perspective of an actual relationship with the Most High God. We bless the Lord today. Shabbat Shalom and greetings from the Remnant Bible School Church. To my women first. The women are obliged to pray. This obligation has a spiritual status. Amen. In the house and outside the house. But we're not called to just stay at home looking pretty, ladies and gentlemen. Amen. There is actually an extent, though, to this obligation. Physically and motherly duties were a challenge, even though they were an obligation. Geographical locations, emotional situations took their toll, amen, on these duties. Some women were cut slightly different for different purposes beyond the house and beyond the community. Sisters like Deborah and Susan, Deborah that followed Christ, and many more, Miriam, Esther, Jochebed, Zipporah, and many more. All prayer that accept the sovereignty of the Most High God, they are heard. All prayers that we ask the Father to accept are at least heard by God. We bless the Lord. The Father is rounding up his people, souls that he has chosen for the hour of the final frontier. Amen. It's not what we did, saints. It's what we did about what we did, or what we didn't do about what we did, that will stand in the courts of accusation. Because we all know, according to Revelation chapter 12, that the devil, he's on the loose accusing the brethren of all kind of crimes. Amen. Day and night, the Bible says. Revelation chapter 12, you can check it out yourself. But in this particular frontier, it is written, predicted, and prophesied that of course he will lose. Men and women, even the children, in the last hour. In the changing of the gods, amen, while it's taking place, right before their very eyes. Oh, I'm sorry. Do you still not see the changing of the gods? From the east to the west, from the north to the south, do you not see that there's a changing of the gods going on? We bless the Lord. It's going on in the physical. It's going on everywhere, I said. It's going on in the spiritual. It's going on in the temple. Women of the old days, women are advised to look to what's been ordered, despite all the calamities that may or may not be going on, despite the daily persecutions, the daily crucifixions. Amen. They're still ordered to pray at least once a day by the Torah. They were permitted, yes, I said permitted, to formulate their prayers as they were led by the Spirit at least once a day. So they could intercede and get down. It became the basis. Amen. It became a custom. Why? Well, one of the reasons why was that they would have the inner strength to stand against the enemies when their husbands were away. They would know what to do to take charge of the house and the relevant prayers that needed to be made. The customs and the traditions and the spontaneous prayers and the orders thereof. When the pangs of grief grip the human spirit, it's an inner power that kicks in for survival. Survival of its host, lest we perish away with grief, as many did over the last 3 years and are still doing today. So yes, all prayers were needed. And all prayers were heard. Amen. Then and even now. All my viewers and all my listeners and all my subscribers know ye this. Yes, we're still in prayer for you. We bless the Lord. And the audience is growing. That's a sign, amen, that it's going in. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your love. And thank you for your patience. The very nature of God is that He is our Father first, and that He is an inclusive divinity of all that He has created and all that He has made. It's the deep that calls to the deep. Let's reason together, said the Lord. One should clear one's minds of all distractions and concentrate, recognizing the presence of the Divine One. Amen. Know the meaning of the prayer that we're making, and then it will be a heartfelt prayer. And the heart really lies about the truth that's within. When it speaks, amen, in the presence of conviction and judgment, redemption and hope, allowing the Most High God to search out the heart and the causes, amen, a purging begins. Things and matters are addressed, and they are no longer hiding in the courtyards of the innermost part of the heart. This allows the Most High God to lay it all on the table of your heart. Bringing forth, amen, is the gateway to your healing. This is the nature of God's healing. To bring forth the enemy, amen, and start to resolve the matter. We don't need to keep hurting inside, not taking or not talking to God about our problems, because we feel that He's too holy, He's too high, so He's not interested in anything that you've got to say. He's not ready to listen to you. The Word of God today says, cast your cares upon Him, for He cares for you. He has the power to hear all at once, and yet individualize our souls, knowing our sounds, reading the letters of our cries in a letter that we write to Him every time we pray. In unison of prayer notes, some in joy, some in laughter, some in praise, some in sadness, and some in tears. All manner of prayers reach His ears. Some in pain, some in sorrow, some in despair, some in stress, some in anxiety, some in depression, some from places of great achievement, and some letters we write singing of Him of thanksgiving and peace and more thanks. Some cry from parts of the world where it would seem all hope is lost, and yet still He hears, yet still He sees, yet still He reads the songs of the love letters written to Him. The sounds of our individual souls make in the One and from the One a substance that comes from the Spirit of the Most High God. Picking up on all our prayers, hearing all our woes, all at the same time. The nature of the Almighty God is of a great light, the greatest light that bears no shame, just covers all blame. Is it not all strong? Is it not all strong over all saints everywhere? The Most High God chose to give audience to a human being that would indeed take the utmost care in His choice of words. He would be most aware of their meaning. God is a God of meaning. God is a God of purpose. It's in His nature. He does no trickery. So too, when we speak to this King of all kings, this Lord of all lords, we ought to take thought of whom it is that we are addressing. We bless the Lord. We need to know the difference between grace and mercy. That also helps in solidifying our prayers. We bless the Lord. He does not bully mankind, but He takes delight in mercy, and He takes delight in forgiveness. Why? Because our weaknesses are His strength. Because we make Him operable in our life by confessing, by laying out our weaknesses. We bless the Lord. And even the things that we call strengths, those are weak before Him. We need to understand that. He is strong in His mercy. He is strong in His forgiveness. And He is divine in His divinity. In conclusion to this part, the Father can answer in many ways, including silence. We are witnesses of the changing of the gods. The Father strengthens our inner core in grief, the toughest of all the emotions, to cope with from a human perspective. Father, the Divine One, comes at you as the inclusive divinity. His deep, and he calls unto the deep. Hearer of all hearts, hearer of all heartfelt prayers, searcher of all hearts, searcher of all. It's in his nature. It's in his nature to heal. It's in his nature to make whole. It's in his nature to make you complete, to restore, to revive, to resurrect, to redeem, to forgive, to love, to be merciful, to restore, to replenish. Again, I say revive. These also are natural and normal and in the very nature of God. Amen. His nature is natural. It's a natural habitation that is lit by his light. Where he is, there is no darkness. No darkness prevails. And today he draws us all into the light of his nature within the pages of his book, pertaining to his story as he inspired it. By his spirit did he, and does he, commit mankind to continue. We bless the Lord, giving respite, lest any wish to at least hear the call, to call unto the Father while he may be found. To many he has strengthened the bars of their gates, blessed their children right in their midst. He who makes your borders strong and peaceful, Psalm 147, dispatches his utterances earthward. How swiftly his commandments run and his revelations fulfill. Let us praise God, people. He commanded and we were created. He relates his word to Jacob, Psalms 148. He established us forever and forever. He issued a decree that will not change, saints. To the blessed God we shall offer sweet melodies to proclaim praises, each man and each woman to their calling, amen. You shall love the Lord thy God with all your heart, soul, mind, and all your resources. Shema. Deuteronomy 6:5-9. Let these matters that I command you today be upon your heart, amen. We should be saying, bring us back, our Father, to your teaching, our Father, and bring us new, renewing, our King. Influence us to turn to thee in perfected repentance, amen. It's not overnight for everyone. Patience is in his nature. It's the nature of God, thank God, right? We pray for his wonders and his favors in every season, amen. Incline your ear, O God. Open your eyes and see our problems. Not because we are holy do we pray, but because we know and we believe that you are a God of the greatest compassion, amen. You see, I'm giving you little prayers as we go along. You can pick them out. You can rewind this video, amen, and just write down the words of that prayer and just help yourself. We bless the Lord. Amen. They're teaching you a lot of things out there, amen. Bless the Lord, but I don't see them teaching you how to really pray. Some need help. Some need lines to say. But no one's helping them. No one's teaching or praying with them or for them. Amen. A prayer that is heartfelt. Prayer where they can see and know that you're involved. A prayer that's actually making a difference. You can see the changes. Amen. Where you can look up and you can say, I know that was God. Amen. So we love to encourage you. Amen. And slip some little prayers in the videos here and there. We know some don't like it, but bless the Lord. We press along, saints. Prayer lines to try and help improve prayers where improvement may be needed. Or maybe one just loves the lines. Amen. They just love the patriarchs of the old and want to pray. The ones who were of old and ancient. Being the head and not the tail, we bless the Lord. The Father's great name will stand for us in the hour of stress. If we had the truth in any way, and in any part of the chambers of our hearts, we will bring life to it as a reality when we sound the words of remembrance of this truth into the ears of the Most High. How? The Holy Spirit in you, amen, with groanings and utterances. The Holy Spirit, when it's not quenched, can speak to the Father. We bless the Lord from your inner man, amen. The inner core of your soul. Done one on the soul already. Try to remember these things and your war with the consistent prayer life. Whether you be male or whether you be female, amen, this war will cease. I said the war will cease. Time will come because you've resisted the devil. He's got to flee. Space will come. Respite will come. The love of it will come. The Father will bring it as a gift from him to you. Amen. With long life will I satisfy thee, saith the Lord. Psalms 91, Deuteronomy 30, verse 1 to 10. The Most High God will circumcise your hearts and the hearts of your offspring to love God with all your hearts and with all your soul, that you, amen, may live. And the Most High God will prosper thee in all thy handiwork. And when you heed him to observe his commandments and his decrees that are written in the book of the Torah, that book that Jesus carried around, amen, that he fulfilled, amen, that he taught, amen, that he embraced, amen, as a light and a teaching for the Most High God, his Father, may our eyes see and our hearts rejoice at the saints. All tears will be wiped away from your eyes with the loving and the soft fingertips of the true Father, while whispering in our anxious ears, I know, I understand, I love you, come, welcome. Now those are some good words to hear, amen, after this dark life here. Oh Lord, please, make us not needful of the gifts of human hands. Do not make us dependent on our oppressors. We are believers whom you do not require to beg. You are our shepherd of shepherds, our sovereignty, our creator, the Holy One of Jacob, our ancestor, amen, shepherd. Be bountiful with us, O Lord. Amen. There's another word. It is written that the pasture that belongs to the Lord will be thankful forever, for they know full well what they have been saved from. We bless the Lord. Today I pray that here on the Remnant Bible School Church, amen, that we are painted by his words the very nature of a little crack at the lid opening to peep inside. Very nature of God. How his people order, his peaceful order demands the same. Wherever he is welcome, even if the peace dwells only in the inner man, in the midst of the flames, bless the Lord, and the flood, he says, I know, I see, I understand, I love you, welcome. Today, God bless you, and amen. I know that the Spirit and the Bride are still saying come. Entering into your upper room time, we bless the Lord. Enter in soberly and orderly, humbly, sincerely, and faithfully, and then you come to him. When you come to him, he is all forgiving, all ready to forgive you. Come to him releasing anything that you're holding, that you're binding to your soul. Come to him believing in all that he has said and all that he has promised. Come to him trusting in his word, amen, in his promises, amen, and in his commandments, amen, that they are true and they are right. Cleanse your mind, your heart, and your soul with this belief. It's a step to the order of sanctification and purification, amen. Come to him, giving him thanks for the past, the present, and the future, amen. Come to him seeking the daily portion of your bread and what he has for you. Come to him laying it all out, amen, in the first hour, cleansing out all the spots and wrinkles that may be in your garments. We bless the Lord. Come to him for enlightenment and revelation, and come to him in the midst of peace. Enter in, acclaiming the space given to us for worship. Believers, enter in your authority, amen, with the light of the word and the word in the light. Enter in as witnesses of his outfit, by keeping his Sabbath. Come to him. Come with all that ails thee, all that concerns thee, and see what he will do. We bless the Lord. We're going to enter in. Amen. With body, mind, spirit, and soul for restoration. His testament. We're going to enter into it. The unified holiness. Enter in his space where all is more than enough. We bless the Lord. Enter into that upper room experience. Upper room experiences are when you can actually get into the space where there's nothing at all but God. I said you enter into a space where there's nothing at all but you and God. In your mind, on your mind, upper room, you hear nothing. You're silent to the world, amen, but you're open to Most High God. The upper room prayer life experiences is when you feel the changes in your voice as you climb, in your spirit, in your prayer, as you climb, in your authority, taking the stand, not against anything human, but standing in the spirit realm, amen, binding everything in the spirit world that is against the word of God and your peace of mind. You entering into the spiritual planes of the upper world in the upper room. An experience with the Divine One welcomes all that can get to that space where you'll find your equilibrium. You'll find the antibiotic right there. Is all still and at peaceful in that place of balance? Then you'll find stability. Then you'll find collectiveness, calm and composure, at least while you're there. The upper room prayer life experiences are addictive to any trier. It's a good thing to be hooked on, amen. The steadfastness of the upper room experiences, amen, are missed. We bless the Lord. People get tired. Once they get baptized, they think they've fulfilled all righteousness. There's nothing else to do. We don't need to pray. We don't need to do anything. Just sit here and follow the leader. What's the purpose of the experience? Wait for it. It builds, it restores, it rekindles our kingdom relationship with God. When one has a kingdom relationship with God, they hunger for that upper room experience. Amen. They expect it every time they pray. It's not easily attained, this height. However, it is guarded three times a day by the mindset of your disciplinary actions towards it. That's what guards it. It's a mindset. They go to the Father. They enter the upper room experience, peeking on one accord in the spirit of prayer, in the spirit of praise. Then out will come, amen, the praises of the Lord. Rivers of praise, rivers of prayer, rivers of testimony and worship will start to flow. The sense of cleanness is priceless. Only God can set the conscience free. Only God can forgive sins and revive and resolve and recondition. Only God can fix the broken heart, mend the broken heart, the broken vessels and the broken minds. Only the Divine One can show up our spots, amen, with the truth and the brightness of the word of his spirit. Every day and every minute and every hour, the Most High looks down and he listens to the sweet sound of the believer's prayers, watching the wrongdoers, waiting for them to change their minds and to change their hearts and to come. In the upper room, amen, the song, even me, let some drops now fall on me, be a song to remember. He wants and he wishes that we would all enter the courts of praise. Even me, Lord, today God know, amen, that he wishes to bless you and keep you sweet. He's asking you to seek him out in that upper room time alone with him, amen, and just to pray. If we have a relationship with the Father, he wouldn't deny it. Don't let the devil kill that relationship. Come to the faithful one. But we must have one ambition, and that would be to get closer to God. This is no sin. Craving the upper room time, amen, is no sin. Ambition to get closer to God is no sin. craving the upper room time. Brethren, today I tell you, it's no sin. Basking in the equilibrium of the Most High God, I tell you the truth, it's no sin. Taking away from the presence of God peace and joy and lightness and compassion and mercy and grace and love and forgiveness is no sin. I'm going to say that again. Taking away from the presence of the Most High God, forgiveness, joy, peace, compassion, mercy, grace, love is no sin. Righteousness converts the nations. Peace causes wars to silence. When the changing of the guards is completed, then shall the hour of decision be upon us. However, always remember, if you practice the upper room prayer with the Father in a calm and a peaceable stability, amen, it's stability that will dwell and strengthen your inner walls of your gates. Your vineyard will flourish, amen, with the abundance from the Father. Life more abundantly, just like Jesus said. Safeguard your hearts, amen, from further attack or pain. Safeguard your home from invasion of demonic forces. Safeguard your witness's outfit. Safeguard your lifestyle. Safeguard your song. Safeguard your shimsha, your joy. Safeguard your Holy Spirit relationship and your experience of healing, your peace and your deliverance and your joy in the presence of the Most High God. Divine acknowledgement, we bless the Lord, is a portion of the remembrance. The remembrance of recalling the great Exodus. The remembrance of recognition that God destroyed evil cities. Amen. Caused great waters to fall on us when we were wicked. The remembrance of the commemoration of his victories over all his battles and over all his wars. The remembrance of recollection that he raised the Nazarene from the tomb. Amen. Renaissance. The remembrance showing respect to his holy days. The remembrance to show honor to his name and call it when we need it only. Amen. When we read and we discuss and we practice what we have read, we can then remember the Most High God, that he is a divine acknowledgement, the divine one, amen. Those who walk and live in divine acknowledgement, we receive a bear witness to the words to John. Blessed are the readers and the hearers of Revelation chapter last. From all the spirits which are before his throne, he has made us kings and priests unto God, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Exodus 19 and 6. You shall be unto me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. This speak to the children of Israel. Say it to the believers. Believing alone, won't cut it. How we treat each other very much counts. Always remember that. Isaiah 61 and 6. You shall be named priest of the Lord, being found approved, being found qualified and all knowledgeable in the things of God. Men shall call you ministers of our God, and you shall eat the riches of the Gentiles, and their glory you shall boast. Peter 2 and 5, ye also are lively stones, build up a spiritual house of a holy priesthood, already by faith believing, call of a spiritual sacrifice, Revelation 1 and 6, made kings and priests unto God the Father, Revelation 20 and 6, blessed and holy is he or she that has part in the first resurrection, they shall be called the priests of God and of Christ, and shall reign with him, amen, 1,000 years. Who shall be made the priest? Among all them that obey the commandments to stand, to return, to repent, and to revive. We bless the Lord. Jesus ordered us to save that which is ready to die. Amen. Of the remainder of your health, of the remainder of your life, walk with God. Whatever it may be, it's worth seeking it out to save it before it dies. and continue to walk in the ways of the destined priests of God. Amen. We take our assurance from a Father of divinity and ability. Romans 4:21. Catch that one. Amen. Grounded in Christ, we bless the Lord. 2 Corinthians 1:20. Grounded in Christ to the glory of God. Psalm 30:5. Remembering his anger endures but for a moment. He carries not grudges and malices like people do. Amen. The light of his divinity is the very nature of God. And is that whomsoever believes in Yeshua will not abide in darkness. John 12:46. Amen. No way. All things are possible to them that believe. Mark 9:23. The divine cares. He cares for the sick. Psalms 41:3. The Lord will bring strength to them, and upon their beds of languishing, then he will make all their beds of sicknesses to be down. They rise up. That's why Jesus said, take up your bed and walk. Psalm 50:15. Psalm 94:12. Psalms 138:7. Isaiah 43:2. Remember, I'm with thee. Always. Always. Isaiah 43:2. When you pass through your waters, I will be with thee. And through your rivers, they will not overflow thee. And when thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle on thee. Amen. We have membership, amen, in the company of the redeemed. And we believe Revelation 7:13, arrayed in white, amen. Revelation 7:14, went through the greatest of tribulations and testings and trials according to our days. Sufficiency of divine grace is in the Father. His grace can keep those who know and can understand the depths of his mercy. The Sankey man said, oh, depths of mercy, can it be that by God's grace we be set free? And as he bids us, come and see, O Lamb of God, we come. We are those who are led by the Spirit of the Most High God. The new strategy from the enemy is to send out a message that leads to unbelief in the main work of the Nazarene, his crucifixion, resurrection, and his ascension. Why? This would mean that King David's vision and Psalms pertaining to the crucifixion was a lie. It would mean that we deny Christ and that we doubt him before the Father who is in heaven, wearing the garments of Anti. The Father would say, I never knew you. He is no cosmic teddy bear, ladies and gentlemen. He would tell you, depart from me, you are a worker of iniquity. Satan does not want you to stop doing the things that you regret. God wants you to stop doing the things that you regret. The Father says, come unto me. The devil says, leave it till later. The enemy wants those in the valley that do not believe not to trust Christ. But Isaiah 53 is telling us clearly that what he would experience when he came here. Satan brings sources that conflict and contradict the Genesis altogether. He wants to wipe out the warnings of Yeshua HaMashiach and his return, so that no one is ready when he comes, let alone prepared. Robbing the souls of the positive experiences that the Father, the Divine, has already passed them through. Exodus 23 warns us to take heed to what Jesus says, including that the Divine not only bottles our tears, but he will dry all tears from our eyes. Amen. We cannot and we will not deny our testimonies, our healing, and our baptism day in whatever language it was given. Our nation, whatever language was given to our nation at the Tower of Babel, we need to open our mouth and give thanks to the Most High God, and all praises to him. Amen. To deny Christ at this point is to say that you never knew him. And if he denies us before the Father, there'll be no plea bargains. Amen. There'll be no bribes or winking at the judge. Amen. This judge on this throne hears nothing but the truth. He doesn't wear a white wig, saints. The Father is natural in the spirit, amen, of divinity. He's not a cosmic teddy bear, but yet still divine. I love it. Hold fast to that which he has called you initially. We bless the Lord. That which delivered you, amen. That which gave you faith and a path, a life, an expected end. We are in the time of the great deception. Do you see it? Do you feel it? Do you hear it? It's all around you. They come with their findings. They come with their skepticisms and their scripts. All incomplete. Not authenticized by the generals of the Torah. Amen. Many who are direct descendants of our Bible. Amen. Our character's Bible. The Father is calling souls. Recite. Intelligent. Spiritual. From the Divine One. Blessed is he. He says, come. So let us follow where he leads. The one in all, with all power over all. Remembering the evidence of his power is that we are still here. He has not utterly destroyed the powers of long suffering, amen, and endurance, patience and mercy, compassion and grace, forgiveness and pardon are not matched by anything with any understanding. What fuels him? What makes him total and absolute? His love. His love yields respite for us to draw near, while many totally miss the whole call altogether. Wow. The Father is blessed in his perfection, and we too can be blessed always if we hold fast to him, bless the Lord, and let not go of his arm and his hand. Today, if you hear my voice, we bless the Lord. And you feel that you've heard enough. And you feel that you want to go and have that upper room experience. You've been saved for a long time. He blessed the Lord. You gave your heart to the Lord a long time ago. Or you haven't. You're thinking about it. You're not sure. I need to tell you more. I need to go deeper. I need to open it up more so you can get to know this one God. Maybe you've got 400 gods. And I'm not convincing you to let go of that 400 for one. So I would ask you this, what has he done for you lately? What has your 400 gods done for you lately? I say unto you, and I say it again, hear, O Israel and the world, the Lord our God is one. One God, over all, in all, and about all business. So today, if you want to get to know him, bless the Lord, it's a prayer away. It takes a made up mind. Make up your mind today. Make it up. Amen. Say, no, I've tried everything and everything's failed. Let me try this Jesus that she's talking about. Today, God bless you. Today, God keep you. Today, God cause his light to ever shine upon your lovely soul, blessing you and your family. And may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, rest, remain, and abide with you all, even now and forevermore. From the Remnant Bible School Church, we say Shabbat Shalom.